Hi, my name's Kim Basinger. I'm Freddie Mercury.
My name's Roger Taylor.
And I'm Brian May from Queen.
Hello, I'm John Deacon from Queen, and I'm in Metropolis Studios in London, where the band Queen, which is Freddie, Roger, Brian and myself, has been spending a large part of 1990 recording a new album. The title is Innuendo, and you're going to see some interviews with Roger and Brian about the making of the album and also clips from a couple of the videos. I hope you enjoy it.
Just get on with it.
Within the group, I think we're conscious of trying to use each other to the maximum, and it is a group, and it still sounds like a group, and I think it should be that way. The format of the group hasn't really changed at all. I suppose we're quite proud of the fact that we still are just the four of us, and this album, like all the others, is just our own instrumentation. Yeah. Another one bites the dust.
Another one bites the dust. I think it could be at least a foot taller. And at least 25 pounds heavier, and then he'd be a great bass player.
He's a strange boy, ladies and gentlemen. He's a strange boy.
He's the governor. He's the best. Another one bites the dust. Everybody loves to play his licks, you know.
Like they should be playing mine, you know.
Freddie's a one-off, you know. You don't get too many people like him.
You ask Freddie how much a pint of milk is, forget it. He'll be able to tell you the price of nail lacquer.
Well, maybe we should all say a bit.
No, that was fine. Just get on with it. Otherwise, I'll forget my name and then.
We've been fairly eclectic in our time, and we did branch out. Whenever we got a little bit too far out, people started to moan and groan a bit. And I think what a lot of people wanted to see was a sort of almost a return to the sort of thickly textured guitar, drums, bass, and now I suppose, of course, keyboard synthesizer lineup, and all the big harmonies, the big richly textured things. And now this album is really all about that. It's sort of a continuation of the miracle, but I think it's a lot less poppy, and I think it's richer and it has more depth.
Hey, he used to be a man with a stick in his hand. Oh, did he do? She used to be a woman with a hot dog stand. Oh, did he do?
Well, really, you start in your head. The best way I write is to have no instrument there, I think. And what I do is sing into this little tape recorder, you know, boom, 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 boom. And it's enough of a notebook that when you bring it out and you've got your keyboards and your guitars and studio ready, you can hear what was in your head at the time. Because generally you do hear it all at once, I find. Headlong down the highway, and you're rushing headlong out of control. And you think you're so strong, but there ain't no stopping, and you can't stop rocking, and there's nothing you can, nothing you can, nothing you can do about it. That's the process of growing up, really, I suppose, like any sort of marriage, I suppose. You still come a bit close sometimes. But then, you know, you do go away, and because we're a bit more grown up, you know, you get over your little small grievances. And there's nothing you can, nothing you can, nothing you can do about it. Old bust up points are usually near the end of albums, when serious decisions have to be made, about which songs, which interpretation, which way it should be done, etc., things like that.
Is that democratic?
Oh yeah, it has to be democratic, and it is democratic actually, yeah. And I think to outsiders, I'm sure it must seem that Freddie is the sort of dominating person in the band, and he is very dominating, and he has a very, very important input, but we really do all have quite a say. Nothing you can do about it at all.
I think we are quite selfish with our songs. I think we're quite competitive. But I think that sometimes is the spark which produces that extra edge.
Most of our videos tend to be extravagant in budget alone, if not nothing else. I can live with you, but I can't live without you. I can let you stay. Ooh, but I can't live if you go away. I don't know just how it goes. All I know is I can't live with you.
Very good. Wonderful. Yeah.
Status Quo?
I thought, yeah, they had potential. The ugly one was his name who sings.
I think Innuendo is one of those things which either could go big or nothing. You know, we had the same feelings about, well, Bohemian Rhapsody for one. You know, it's a risk because a lot of people say it's too long, it's too involved, we don't want to play it on the radio. I mean, I think that could happen, in which case it'll die a death. You know, or it could happen that people say this is interesting and new and different, and we'll take a chance.
Track that we've named the album after. And I mean, we're definitely not trying to follow up Bohemian Rhapsody because it's such a one-off anyway, I think that would be impossible. But it's very us, you know, those bitty, odd things, you know, the different changes in mood and temper. And it's just a track I rather like. I rather like its sort of epic, cod epic quality, you know, quite amusing. And it has this sort of weight and heaviness.
Oh, yes, we'll keep on trying. Tread that fine line. Oh, we'll keep on trying. Yeah, just passing our time.
Going to be using something which we haven't done too much of. It's going to be using a lot of animation techniques and all different animation techniques, and with a little story to go with it, and sort of us, I believe, being featured as a sort of four different painting styles.
Come back from doing different stuff thinking, God, I really want to play the guitar, you know. I like the sound that my guitar makes anyway. But I'm very aware of a lot of new input into guitar. You know, there's a lot of great people out there like Steve Vai, Satriani, all those people who, of course, Edward Van Halen, who you're aware of. And I listen to those guys and I don't play anything like that. But you get a feeling for what's out there. And I have to say, Jeff Beck, you know, every time I listen to Jeff Beck, my whole view of guitar changes radically, because he's one of these people who is way, way out doing things which you never expect. So that's my kind of model, in a way. You know, I would like people to listen to what I do and say, ah, you took a chance there, you know, this is something a little different. And I would like people to think that it's melodic and it's not just kind of wheedly 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 away to for flash's sake, you know.
Sometimes I get to feeling I was back in the old days long ago, when we were kids, when we were young, things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young, the sun was always shining. We just live for fun. Sometimes it seems like lately, I just don't know. The rest of my life's been just a show. Those were the days of our lives. The bad things in life were so few.
We've been really recording this album on and off for over a year, just over a year, and I'm very pleased with it. Really, I enjoyed, these days I find myself enjoying writing at home a lot. But apart from that, musically, I really want to take a bit of a rest, actually, because we've got this album done. I think I know Queen believe that it's one of the best things we've done, I think. I know they do. And I'd just like to rest a little bit now, I think.
I'm knitting with only one needle, unraveling fast, it's true. I'm driving only three wheels these days, but my dear, how about you?
going slightly mad. I'm going slightly mad. It finally happened, happened. It finally happened. Oh, it finally happened. I'm slightly mad.
Oh dear.
Well, I'm not very good at resting. That's the trouble. I have to go and if I'm not down in the downstairs room writing or something, I'm sort of fiddling with things or maybe buying pictures or something and just sort of fiddling with the house. I have to be fiddling with something. So, you know, I mean, if I rest, I may maybe go away to ski or do some boating.
So, I mean, do you collect art or is it just you just pick up things you like the look of?
Well, I do collect a bit, yes. I quite like some modern pieces.
We're all God's people.
Yes, I think we're always conscious of people listening to it in various ways. Yeah, I think you first of all you think, what am I trying to say myself? And then you think, how's the band going to interpret this? And then you think, how's she going to feel about it? How's he going to feel about it? And we do, we say that now and again. We say, how's Mary Potts going to feel about this, you know? And sometimes it's a joke because sometimes we pore over, you know, one little phrase or the tuning of one note and you think, well, Mary Potts of Biggleswade won't actually complain if it's a little bit out, you know. So you try and not be too obsessive about things. But we're always conscious that people have a view of us and expect something of us. And we do play to our audience, I think. Yeah, it's very important. You can't create music in a vacuum.
Show must go! Shout out!